That took me a little bit to finagle it out of the controller, but look what we discovered behind it. Yep, that's a burn mark, and that's right behind slot number one. And you can see the damage there. The electricity went right through all of that and blew out the connectors right there. That's why nothing was working on that module, because it wasn't even making a connection right there. It blew out all the solder. So we're gonna go ahead and replace everything in this controller with the exception of the case, because it just makes it easier to leave the case on the wall and rebuild the controller. So that's what we're gonna do. Let me go ahead and take all the parts out of that controller and put them into this one. And then we'll proceed to do the same thing with the other one next to it. We got the first controller completed. Now we're on to the second one. I've already dismantled the new parts out of the new controller, and I've already pulled all of the screws out of the existing controller. While I was pulling that screw out in the middle there, I noticed all that char marks. So let's look together to see what kind of damage is going on behind here. Whoa, I already see some black. Oh, wow. Yep. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. For sure. That's where most of the damage went. Holy crap. All right. Well, the new one looks like this. So there you go. Comparison, you know, exploded, not exploded, exploded. And this will be so easy to replace. All we got to do is slide this in. Now, of course, we'll have to pull the remote wire over that little notch right there, but that goes in like that. We'll put the 9 screws back in the back plane. We'll put the 2 screws back into the new transformer, get it all connected, wire it up, turn it on. Here's a quick little tech tip for you. To detect a bad module in an IC2 controller or an HCC controller, go ahead and check the ohms on one circuit. And when you see some crazy crap like this, 200 ohms, which is way above, then try pulling out modules until that reading changes. Let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna have to put my phone down to show you this, but I'm gonna pull out this bottom right module right here, and you'll see what happens to that reading right there. I'll leave that on my knee, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull out the module, and boom. Would you look at that? 38 ohms. That tells me that the module on the bottom right here that I just pulled out is the problem. So we can go ahead and replace that module, retest, and I'm willing to bet we'll get better readings. With the test probes on the same 2 terminals, we've got the new module installed, and look at that, we got a good reading. So that was a bad module. We actually have to do the same test on this controller to the right, and I imagine I'm gonna be replacing a module or two in there too. Well, I hope you liked that video. We got both of those controllers back up and running by replacing all of the internal parts. I showed you exactly what happened to that controller to cause the problem. The next step is going to be installing a ground rod. I'm going to take a little bit of a lunch break here, edit this video and post it. And the next video will be the ground rod video, because earth grounding the controller in South Florida is super important.